Hello guys, welcome back with me, Cho2025. Today we're gonna talk how to make dynamic prompts in comfyui. We are going to use comfyui-dynamicprompts from adieyal. Link on the video description. To install it, simply copy the GitHub link. Open Manager and then click Install via Git URL. Paste the link and click OK. Or simply click Custom Node in Manager and search for Dynamic Prompt and install from there. Either way, you need to restart your comfy. I will not install it since I already have them, but this is very easy, so no need to show it to you. There are 5 ways to use dynamic prompts using this library. There are random prompt, combinatorial prompts, I'm feeling lucky, magic prompt, and Jinja2 templates. We're gonna start from random prompts. Random prompt is a dynamic prompt that implements standard wildcard mode for random sampling of variants and wildcards. Variants allow you to randomly generate one or more options from a list of possibilities. They can be weighted and you can control the number of options to be chosen. To create a variant, wrap your options in curly brackets and separate them with a vertical bar. For example, I make a prompt for character using address. The color will be set for 5 options. There are red, blue, black, and white. Here I put it without weight every time I generate. The prompt will randomly select from those 5 options. Now connect this random prompts with clip text encode. Make sure to connect it to the top left of the text box and make sure the green thing on that place is highlighted. We could also will use show text node to see what actually written. Here we see that the text is randomly selected without any rules. The result really random without our control. If you want to give weight, so some options could appear more and some options could show less. You could do it by give the probability in decimal before the options and add double colon between them. Here are some examples. In this example, we could see that red dress appears more often because we gave them the most change to show up. You could also make that it could select more than one options. To do that, after the opening curly bracket, add number and double dollar before the option. Values are chosen without replacement, so you won't get repeats. Here are the example. Here we see that it selects more than one text, but the separator is comma and the prompt became strange. If you don't want to add comma as separator to those that are selected, you could add custom separator. After the double dollar, add the new separator, and after that, close it with double dollar sign again, and then add the option. Here are the example. Here we found that using an in-between really make the result better. But if you want to have different hair color with the cloth, you could do this by using separator as part of the prompt. Here is the example. Now we see that the result is changing the hair color and dress color. You could also have variant inside variant. For example, like this, I split the red into light red and dark red, so to the blue and green. Here are some examples. In this example, we see that if we got red, blue, or green, the AI will randomly select between dark color and light color. This will indirectly reduce the chance of this color to get selected, since when the red color selected, there will be 50-50 chance it will be dark or light. If you want to make a range, so it could select not only one number, but it could select three and more, you could. Before the sign, add the first range, follow with the dash or minus sign, and follow again by the last range, then add the double dollar sign. Here are the example. If you not gave a first range or the last range, it will mean that it will use the minimal value for the first range and the max value for the last range. Now about wildcards. Wilds are placeholders that inject values from a file into your prompt. Create a file with the desired values and use double underscores double to indicate the wildcard. Make sure you have the same file name at comfyui.com/custom-node/comfyui-dynamicprompts/wildcards. Here for the example, I have this color.txt file on the wildcards folder. Here are the content. Now let's add a new wildcards on our prompt. Use double underscores, color double underscores. Here are the example. If you upload or put the wildcard file after the comfy UI start, you need to restart comfy again. Comfy only can read file that are already there when comfy started. Rule for multiple value also work in wildcards. Make sure to add curly bracket before that. Wildcards also can contain variants, so you could add variant in the text file. You could also add wildcards in wildcards, so you could add other wildcards file name. You could even add wildcard name by adding asterisk sign, so you could call more than one file. You could also add nested and use YML and JSON file, but I think it is too complicated to explain and people will hardly ever use it, so I'm gonna skip it. Lastly, we can use variables. We define variable by using dollar sign, then after that add curly bracket. Inside it use variable name equal value. To force the immediate evaluation of a variable's value, add an exclamation mark before the value. To use the variable, use dollar sign, follow by curly bracket, and inside the curly bracket, put the variable name. Immediate evaluation is great when you want to have consistent result for the one randomly selected. Example, if you want the prompt to have a same color of between cloth and pants. Here are the example. As you can see with immediate evaluation, the color is not changing for all variable. But on the next generation, the color will also stay. Non-immediate evaluation is simply putting the same option over and over again. The variable value is decided every time it call. Here are the example. Now let's learn combinatorial prompts. Unlike random prompt, which select the options randomly in combinatorial prompts, it iterates through every possible combination of random values in a prompt. So it is very great if you want to create a bunch of image with little prompt variation. All the syntax on the random prompt is also working here. Here are the example. You could also use wildcards, but it will not move sequential, but it will iterate all the value first before repeat itself. Now let's learn I'm feeling lucky. This prompt uses the given prompt to download a related prompt from lexica.art. So no need to add long prompt. Simply add a simple prompt and hope for the best. Here are the example. Using I'm feeling lucky might generate error like too many requests for URL. If that happened, delete the node and add again the node. Magic prompt using Gustavus's magic prompt model automatically generate new prompts from the input. Trained on 80,000 prompts from lexica.art, it can help give you interesting new prompts on a given subject. The first time you use it, the model is downloaded. It is approximately 500 megabyte, and so will take some time depending on how fast your connection is. It will also take a few seconds on first activation as the model is loaded into memory. Note if you're low in VRAM, you might get a CUDA error. Here are some examples. Lastly is Jinja2 Template. Basically is using Jinja2 Template to create node. Using Jinja2 Template, you could use looping for next. Also, you could use if conditional. This is great, but I think this is too complicated for me to explain on this video. And I don't really see people using this for simple use. So I will not talk about it in this video. If you somehow knew about Jinja2 Template, you could actually use it here. Anyway, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode, and have a nice day. Please subscribe.